In this tutorial, we're gonna have some fun with expressions. You'll learn how to create this cool little shape layer animation on just one layer using some simple coding, parenting values, and making slight mathematical adjustments to expressions. This tutorial isn't just about this animation. It's about understanding the relationship between values, understanding how to affect settings with parenting, and how making even the slightest adjustment can have a significant impact on your designs. You can use these techniques in any number of other situations. You'll definitely wanna stick around to learn all about these really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Let's just go ahead and right click in this area, this to the left of our timeline, and I'm going to create a new shape layer. Open that up, add in a group. Within that group, I want to add in a rectangle, and I want to give that rectangle a stroke. Open this up just a little bit. Maybe increase our stroke width just a bit. With group selected, go to add and added trim paths. And you really wanna make sure you have all of these settings within the same group. So we're gonna open that up and let's put a keyframe at the beginning of our animation for start and end percentage, make both of those zero. Now I'm gonna shift page down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times and make both of those values 100. So now if you scrub through here, you'll see that nothing's happening and that's because these values are offsetting each other. Select all of those keyframes in F9 to make those easy ease. Now you want to select this first end percentage keyframe. Go to your graph editor and just pull that handle all the way to the right. And then you want to take your last start percentage keyframe and we're going to go in the opposite direction. So just pull that all the way to the left. Watch that play back and here is our animation. We're going to start stacking these groups and linking some values up. So first I want to change the name of this group 1 to control. So everything we'll be doing eventually will be done from this control group. Let's duplicate that, rename that to O1, and go to our Finder toolbar, type in size, parent this size setting from our one group to the control group. Open that up, plus open bracket 100, 100. So this is going to increase the size of this rectangle by 100 pixels on both the X and the Y value. Kind of scrub through here, we see that's exactly what we got. Select shape layer 1 again and type in round for roundness. And we want to go ahead and link up our roundness. So that way, if we adjust the roundness of our control group, we see that it affects our one group. Type in width. And we want to select the stroke width. And we just want to parent that down to the stroke width of control group. Let's divide this by 2. What that's going to do is decrease our second stroke by 1/2. We can see that the control group stroke width is 11 and the stroke width on group 1 is 5.5. You can change this to anything. Say we'll make that 20 and we see the stroke width of group 1 is 10. We want to do one more property. So just type in offset and let's just pick whip from group 1 down to the control group. Open that up and we just want to add in plus 10. The control group is set to an offset of 0 degrees. Group 1 is set to 10 degrees, so it's slightly off. Okay, and then if you hit U to bring up your keyframes, we're just going to offset these animations by, we'll say, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 frames. So grab this second set here. If we watch that play back, we have something that looks kind of like that. So our stroke width is half the size, our offset is slightly offset, and the size of our box is 100 pixels larger on the X and Y values. Duplicate group 1 and then we'll have group 2. Let's open up group 2. Now on our group 1, we had a rectangle path size parented and then we added 100 pixels on each. So I'm just going to make this 200. Okay, we can close that up and then we want to go down to our trim paths option here and we have our trim paths offset plus 10. So let's make that plus 20. Open up our stroke setting here and we want to now divide this by 4. Duplicate group 2. Open up our rectangle path size settings, and I'm just going to increase this. Instead of doubling it, I'm just going to go up by another 100 pixels. So we have 100, 200, 300. You can close that up, open up our trim paths. Again, let's just go up by another 10 pixels. So 10, 20, and 30. And then the stroke width, just to keep this all consistent, we divide it by 2, 4. Let's divide this by 6. Press U to bring up our keyframes. Page down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we're going to grab these keyframes, move them down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on page down, and grab this last set. So just a cool little shape layer animation. Now, the thing that's kind of cool is that we've linked up so many of these properties, we can start to make some changes. Remember that we have our roundness parented. Type in round. All of these roundness values are parented to this control group roundness. Increase that roundness, and we get something that looks quite different. If you want this to be a complete circle, just make your size settings equal 350 by 350. So this is a really cool way that you can make some really quick animations, and just by changing a few settings, you get some pretty cool effects. I'm going to type in stroke, and then we get all of our stroke values. Let's manipulate this stroke width right here. So right now it's set to 20. If we increase it, we can see how it affects our other strokes. They all increase, but yet they're still confined to that math that we included. Actually, let's go ahead and make this 40 so that way the math's easier. We can see the stroke on 1 is 20, stroke on 2 is 10, and then the stroke on 3 is 6.7. Now, if we had divided that by 8, we can see that it is 5. We may want to bring in this outer group in just a little bit. This is going to be affected on our size settings. So we have sizes plus 100, 100. Then we have 200, 200. We'll increase the second one by 75. And then this last one, we'll increase that by 50. And we can see the effect that that's going to have on this. If we wanted this end to be a round cap instead of a butt cap, you can type in line and get all of your caps and your joins brought up right here. Even though you have pick whips here, you cannot pick whip one cap to the next. As you can see, it doesn't do anything. Same thing with join. I'm not really sure exactly why the pick whip is in there, because you cannot do it. However, you can grab all of these line caps and then change butt cap to round cap. And now all of your caps are rounded, which may be a look that you prefer instead of having that butt cap. Okay, I'm going to clear out my search bar, open that back up, and just open up my control group. Come somewhere here in the middle, and I'm going to just spread this out a little bit so we have more of a rectangle setting and kind of decrease my roundness. Go back to your finder bar and type in path. You can actually adjust these directions here. Make group 1 go in the opposite direction and make group 3 go in that same direction. You can watch that play back, and you can see how this will affect your animation in a pretty cool way. You can also have them kind of randomly going in different directions. You can have them all going in the same direction like we did originally, but going in the opposite direction that we originally had it in. Manipulate the offset of this main control, and this will affect all of the offset degrees. If we type in offset, we can see what's going on here. So maybe you want to increase this one by 30 degrees, 60, and make this last one 90. So as you can see, you can get some pretty cool results just by linking up a few of these properties and adding in some mathematical tweaks, whether it's addition, subtraction, division, or multiplication. Just kind of play around with this and see what you can come up with. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode, and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds and virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.